Let's talk about Mike Tyson. Yeah, Mike Tyson before the Lennox Lewis fight in 2002. What most don't know is the boxer visited Cuba before the fight. Cuba. Let's talk about Cuba. Cuba, the largest single island. In 1898, Cuba gained independence. Wow, Spanish-American War has something to do with that. Castro's revolution took over in 1959 along with his friend Che Guevara, who wanted to unseat Batista. Batista ran to the Dominican Republic and then to Spain, where he lived out the rest of his days and died at the age of 73. In 1961, the Bay of Pigs happened. Y'all remember that? America was so mad they placed embargoes all over Cuba. Didn't want to do any business with them because they was connected to the Soviet Union. You remember the Cold War. Now, some people fled to the United States. Some people fled to other countries. Some people like Cuba. Some people hate Cuba and its government. Not the actual people, because there's some good people in Cuba. But each side has their own reasons to why they like it, why they hate it. That's not for me to discuss. But let's talk about this. Let's talk about Tyson's visit there and what went into that visit. When Tyson visited Cuba, this was around a time when the full embargo was still set by the U.S. government and it was still upheld around 2002, which a Republican rep wanted Mike Tyson investigated for traveling to Cuba. Rep Lincoln Diaz Balart and the Cuban American National Foundation said at the time that Tyson should be prosecuted for his trip to Cuba. They called into question whether he received permission to visit the country, which is still has an embargo set by the U.S. at the time. The rep sent a letter to the Treasury Department asking if he was granted permission because the Treasury Department enforces the embargo. And at the time, Tyson had a large tattoo of Che Guevara tattooed on his stomach. Tyson always had some wild moments. When Mike Tyson said this, it was months before he would face off with Lennox Lewis.
Most brutal in Michigan, most ruthless champion there's ever been. There's no one can stop me. Lennox is a conqueror. No, I'm Alexander. He's no Alexander. I'm the best ever. There's never been anybody as ruthless. I'm Sonny Liston. I'm Jack Dempsey. There's no one like me. I'm from Nairclough. There's no one that can match me. My style is impetuous. My defense is impregnable. And I'm just ferocious. I want your heart. I want to eat his children. Praise be to Allah.
Are you saying now, Mike?
Crazy. Mike Tyson even confronted Michael Jordan about his connection to Robin Givens, which went something like this. I know you effed my chick, and I'm being real censored right now. The story is Jordan got out of there. Mike Tyson has traveled to Istanbul, South Africa, India, Tokyo, Denmark, Scotland. Man, he's been to a lot of places. See, Mike Tyson was banned from the UK. Now he's banned, but he was allowed to enter Britain years ago, even with a feminist group attempting to block his entry then, with no success. See, when Mike Tyson landed, he got out and he walked the streets with a crowd of 2,000 gathering around him. The police had to escort him to the police station. Crazy, right? See, Mike Tyson felt like a prisoner in his boxing career at times. But he's a fighter and a student of boxing.
Don't let me out the hotel. They just let me go to training and come back like I'm some Neanderthal and I can't associate with people. So I had to hit all the maids. And I guess hitting means having sex with the men.
I know what you mean.
I don't want you to think I'm hitting the men.
The story goes Mike Tyson goes to Cuba just to get his mind off things. He checks in a hotel Havana with two bodyguards, just chilling. And he was upstairs for most of the time in his hotel, chilling, relaxing. Didn't do anything, didn't do much. So one time, Tyson came downstairs. He saw all of these cameras in his face. Tyson loses it. He's pissed. I get these cameras, I'm trying to chill. They kept shooting, clicking. Tyson was upset. He grabbed the bowl with some objects in it and started tossing them. And then there's accounts that he actually hit somebody in the neck with something. There were never any police reports, anything filed, no arrest or anything. Nobody went to jail. Tyson went out to Cuba to just chill, relax. There's even an account that I got on video of a guy out in Cuba saying Mike Tyson was giving out lots of money, $100 bills to all of the people out there in Cuba. There's accounts of this. So shout out to Mike Tyson for his trip out there. Whether you like Cuba or you don't, just giving you an account of Mike Tyson's trip. Peace.